Hello guys, so in this video we are going to create a night background similar to this. So let's get started. Open Inkscape and go to File and go to Document Properties, and in Display Unit select Pixel. And we don't want page background, so untick this one. Now here I have created two layers. On layer 2 we have a rectangle which is of a gray color, which is locked so that we cannot move it, and we are going to create all our art on layer 1. So if you want to create a layer, you can just select this plus sign, add it, and you can move it down like that. So we don't need this, delete one. Now if you don't have layer window here, you can go to layer and select layers. We also need align and distribute window, so go to object and select align and distribute. We also need fill and stroke window, go to object and select fill and stroke. Here you can see I have some colors which we are going to use in our art, so you can check the codes and use them. So to pan, you can select the mouse scroll button and just move your mouse, and to zoom in and out, hold control key and scroll your mouse to zoom in and out. So now select this rectangle tool, click and just drag it to create a rectangle. Let's go to layer and we want to create art on layer 1. So let's select layer 1, click and drag to create a rectangle. We don't want this curve here, so select this node tool, hold control and just move it up, so we get a point edge. Now let's select a transform tool and change its size. So untick this lock icon, and in width we set it to 1280 and 720 and 720. Now let's move this here and let's zoom in. Now let's select the gradient tool and we want linear gradient. Now select the top and just drag it down. Now select this node here, go to fill and stroke, select the color picker, and we need this color. Select this node here and we will increase our alpha to its max. Select the color picker and select this color here. Select this rectangle, select the transform tool, select the rectangle, right click, duplicate, and just reduce its height like this. Let's flip it on vertical axis and this will be our water. And now select the polygon tool, select the polygon, need a corner 3, so we can create a triangle. Hold control and click and drag to create a triangle. Let's select the color picker and select this color. Now select the transform tool. Now holding control, select this arrow and drag it down to reduce its size. Now let's move it here. Let me just reduce its height without holding control and increase its width like this. Okay. Now select this triangle, select this rectangle and shift select the triangle. Go to align and distribute and let's align it on right side, and it's relative to the first selected, which was our rectangle. Now select this one first and then triangle and then align on bottom edge like this. Now let's increase its width again like this. Okay, select, right click, duplicate, holding control move it to the left side. Select this arrow, holding control reduce its size. Let's move it like this. Select this rectangle, right click, duplicate, select both of them with the help of shift key, go to path and select intersection. So only the area which was intersected by both of them remains. Now select this triangle again, right click, duplicate, holding control move it to the left side, select this arrow, hold control, reduce the size. Let's see, it should be between these two. Okay, now let's change the color. Go to fill and stroke and let's change this alpha to 180 and its alpha to 140, and you can see we have some intersection here. So select this one, right click, duplicate, shift select both of them, go to path and select difference. So only the area which was not intersected remains. The next thing is select this, right click, duplicate and flip it on vertical axis, and let's select this rectangular, select this one, go to align and distribute, and we align it on top edge, and let's reduce its height and go to fill and stroke and reduce its alpha to let's say 55. Select this one, right click, duplicate, flip on vertical axis, select the rectangle, shift select this one, go to align and distribute and select this align to top edge, and select this, reduce its alpha by going fill and stroke to let's say 35, lighter than this, and we again have some intersection. So select this one, right click, duplicate, select both of them with the help of shift key, go to path and select difference. Okay, now we are good, and let's reduce its height to say like 8, duplicate, do the same, we don't want the overlapping. Okay, now we have our mountains, we have our sea and their reflection. Next thing is creating trees. So select the triangle or polygon tool and let's create a triangle, holding control create a triangle, and we reduce its size by holding control. Let's move it up here and reduce its width so it becomes like a tree. And now select this rectangle here, select this one and then align it with the help of align bottom edge. Select this, holding control you can move to the left side, control D to duplicate and move to the right, control D, duplicate, 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 select all of them, control D, duplicate, control D, duplicate, control D, duplicate, control D to duplicate. Okay, now select all of them and then just align, right? Next, select this, control D, duplicate, reduce its size holding control key and control D, duplicate. Okay guys, so now we have our trees. Now just select all of them and go to path and make them union so they become a single object, right click, duplicate, and we will flip them on horizontal axis and just see, move them. So let's move it here like this and let's move them by one. Okay, go to fill and stroke and reduce their alpha and let's adjust. Okay, We can reduce their height also. Let's see here, and let's move it here like this. Okay, so now we have our tree. Now select this one, right click, duplicate, flip it on vertical axis, move it down, select this rectangle, select them, go to align distribute and select this one, and we will go to fill and stroke and select this, and then go to fill and stroke and reduce the alpha something, say 90, darker than this one, and let's reduce its height too. So guys, now we have our trees, mountains, river. Let's make a moon. So select the circle tool, holding control click and drag to create a perfect circle, and let's set it alpha to its max. And if it's not a perfect circle, then you can always go to transform and just make width and height similar. Let's change its color to white, right click, duplicate, holding control let's move it to the right side. Let's increase its size. So what you can do is select it, now select this arrow, hold control shift and just move it like this so that we increase its size. Right click, duplicate, holding control move it to the right, hold control shift, increase the size, control D duplicate, control shift, increase the size. Select this one, let's make its alpha to, let's say 150, this one to 100, this one to 50. Now this has to be at a top, and then this one again, let's first select all of them, total, and just align them. Let's select this outer one and make it to the bottom. Select this one, make it bottom and then up by one. Select this one, make it bottom and up by two. Now we have our moon. Back and select all of them, go to path and make, or go to object and make it a group, and holding control let's reduce its size and let's move it here. Let's move it below our, let's move this one below our mountain. So let's move it at the lowest and then by one. Okay, so we have our moon. Maybe reduce its size, it's too big. Okay, let's make stars. So select the circle tool and let's click and drag to create a circle. Right click, duplicate, right click, duplicate, right click, duplicate, right click and duplicate, right click, duplicate, and let's move it here. Reduce this size, right click, duplicate, okay, right click, duplicate, right click, duplicate, right click, duplicate, right click, right click, duplicate, and let's move it here, and again reduce its size holding control, and we can just repeat this process n number of times and create different types of stars. Okay, so now we have our star. Select this one, right click and duplicate, go to path and make it object to path. Select the node tool, select this node here, hold control and move it to the right and make sure this is in line with the top one, and let's make it a little darker. Done. Okay, and let's move it down. Okay, until our this shadow tree, the back tree is visible. Now let's make some clouds. So select the rectangle tool, click and drag to create a rectangle, zoom in. Hold this node here, hold control and just drag it down, create a circle like this, a circular edge, and make it white, and let's change this alpha to 80, right click, duplicate, move it down, right click, duplicate, hold control, select all of them, go to path and make them a single object, a union, just reduce their size like this, maybe little more less alpha. Okay, control D, duplicate and move it down. So I think this one is little down and this one is more down, and let's change their alpha. Okay, so guys, we have created our background. So thank you guys for watching the video, and remember to subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video.